Hi friends, this is Pavani. Can explain one more topic in our Excel. See, here we can see font. In font, what are the options are there? We can see now. So I have taken one table, student number, name, and present and absent. Here, in font, we have different types of options: bold, italic, underline, and styles. Okay. Here, theme fonts. If you want different types of styles, in a styles, if you want different themes, we can select here. Okay, and also here they have number increasing and decreasing. For example, take one table here. Okay, I have taken the table here. Just select it. If you want to increase the styles, or else if you want to change the numbers. Okay, if you want to do like that, just select it. Okay, this heading only if you want to change into a different style. Whatever the heading you want to change, or whatever the topic you want to change, first select that. Okay, select it and go to your home. Select here home menu bar. In home menu bar, we can see here font. Okay, in font, select here themes, fonts. Here we have different types. So if you want to see the difference, just wait. I want to delete this. I want to paste here. So what is that means? I want to cut here and paste here. So what we need to select the shortcut key. Before that, we need to select the data and select Control plus X. Means Control plus X means cut and copy. Okay, and place the cursor, cut and paste. Okay, not copy, cut and paste. If you want to do the paste, Control P. Okay, here we can see Control P and select the data. Okay, just only headings I want to change it. Select here, and here we can see different styles. See, here let's change it. Okay, here we can see different styles. Here we can see different types of styles in these theme fonts. Whatever if you want, you can select here. Here, this. Okay. These are the default themes, like this. Okay. I'm selecting one style here. Okay. And here I want to increase this. Means it is only like student number, name. I want to increase the number size here. So if you want to do that, select here number size is 11, 12, 14, 18. If you want to do, so just select it. Okay, like this. Till where if you want, you can do. But according to the table, how much you want to increase, that much we can increase here. Okay, this one. And if you want to apply the colors for your table, or for a main heading, okay, for subheading, or only for particular cell, if you want to apply, just select the particular cell, or just select two or more cells if you want, just select it. Okay. Before that, there is a bold, italic, and underline. See here, for this table, I want to add the heading. If you want to add the heading, just place the cursor here. I want to write here student data. I'm writing here student data. It should be in a table middle. Okay, it is in L cell. I want to merge these three cells in a single cell. So if you want to do that, just select it here, merge. That's all. Okay, this is called one table. For this, if you want to apply bold, italic, and underline, just here bold, italic means different, it is nothing but different style. Control plus I. Control plus I. For underline, Control plus U. Okay. For bold, Control plus B. Understood? For bold, if you want to do, for italic, for underline, Control plus B. For bold, Control plus I. For italic, Control plus U for underline. See here, we can see different options here itself. Now, see, you want to increase the date, increase the number, this data number, if you want to increase it, just select here, we can increase here, like this, 20, 24, like this, you can increase it, okay, like this. Change the style. If you want to change the style here, you can change the style. Arial or less Arial black, Arial narrow, whatever it may be. If you want to do, just select it. This is the, want to delete the bold, italic, underline, if you want to delete it. Same, what if you want to apply, Control B. If you want to delete also, Control B means bold if you want to remove. Just I am pressing with shortcut, Control B, see, okay, Control I, okay, Control U. Just select it, Control U, Control I, understood? Okay, bold if you want bold, italic, underline, here we go, double underline if you want, just select your double underline, okay, this one. Here next, in font next we have seen here borders, okay, borders if you want to apply. For example, here I am taking one data here, see here I am taking employee details. Employee name, okay. Employee department, like this. I have taken here, okay. Employee name A, B, C, okay. Department. For this I need to apply the colors. If you apply the colors, whatever the cells lines are there will be hided. See you. Understood? Like this. Hide it, right? For these, if you want to add the borders. Okay, if you want to add the borders, just select the table. So go here. Here we can see bottom border, top order, border, left border, right border here. All those you can do like this. Here all borders, okay, we can do here all borders, right, just select here like this, okay. For example, only single if you want to select, for example I'm selecting here two, I'm merging it like this. Here bottom border if you want, see here we can see bottom border, or else here top border like this. Wherever you place the cursor there, if you want the borders, select here left border, right border, no borders, like this. For this I want no borders. If you don't want, just select it here, no borders. We doesn't apply here, no border, like this. Here like this we have different types of borders, right border, left, all borders, outside borders. Outside borders, here this is the outside borders. So depends upon your selected cells we can apply the borders, left, right, or else top, bottom, all those. Thick box border, thick box border if you want, just select here thick box border like this. You can see the difference here. So for this and for this we can see the difference here. Next, if you want here thick bottom border, bottom border first, bottom if you want thick, thick border, bottom, and top if you want thick, same. So place the cursor here, top, like this. Different types we have here, styles in your borders. Top and bottom, top and thick bottom border, top and double bottom border. See here, top and bottom, double if you want, place the cursor and select here top and double. Here we can, okay, like this we can see here, and borders, draw borders if you want to draw the border. For example, here I'm there, I want to draw here. If you want to do that, select here draw border like this, you can draw here. Okay, draw border grid like this. Okay, in MS Word if you want to do, we can do with this help of borders like this. If you want to draw it, we can draw like this, like a table. If you want to draw, you can draw like the table. Okay, here erase borders, the borders you have applied. If you want to erase, just erase it, finish. I'm arising. Okay, just only borders will be arised. Wherever you have applied, there the borders will be arised. Okay, this, like this, that's all. Line colors, if you want to apply the colors for your borders, like this, here select the colors. For example, I'm selecting red color, like this. You can apply the red colors, like this. For it is used for different data, they are based upon your information. For example, this person I want to highlight. So if you want to highlight, just select the border and select it like this. Okay, line style, if you want to select, here we can see so many types of lines. See here, for this, like this, if you want to do it. Okay, based on our selection we can do here. These are the different types of borders. Here, like, you want to do like this, like this. Next, select here. More borders, if you want more borders, same, none, outline, whatever that we have repeated here, the same borders will be there. The text, like this. Okay, I have selected two cells. For this I want to apply, just go here, more borders, here the whatever the selected cells is, we can appear in this box. See, if you want like this here, like this here, we can do it. Okay, like this. Different types of borders, if you want, select here, and different types of borders we can see here. Okay, this is the borders in your font. Okay, and next, if you want to apply the colors, we can apply the different types of colors. For example, for data, if you want to apply the colors, I want to erase these borders. If you want to do that, if you want to erase this total borders what you have applied, select here, erase, select and erase it. Wherever you have applied the borders, only it will be erased, like this. It has been erased. Erase. Okay. You want to erase, you can erase. Here also, if you want to erase, erase like this. Okay. Next, colors. If you want to apply the colors here, see, just for selected cells, if you want to apply, for this example, I'll take, for this, if you want to apply the color, select it. Here we can apply the colors. Okay. These are the different colors if you want to apply. The theme colors, want to do theme colors, select. Here we have no colors, means no fill. More colors if you want, select here, more colors, and here we can apply it like this. Okay, for text, if you want to apply the colors, select here, text, here we can see, you can apply the text colors. Okay, more if you want, we can apply it, more colors like this. So total, if you want to apply, select it, go near bucket and select the colors like this. Okay, and text colors, we can apply here text colors. Okay, next here, this is the increase in font size. Here we can see with the help of the numbers, we can increase and we can decrease. And like that only, here we can see here capital A and the small capital A. Okay, here if you want to increase it, like this, increase. See, we can observe here, if I am increasing this A, here also the numbers will be increased, 28, see, 36. Okay, if you want to decrease, just decrease, the numbers also will be decreased, like this, just changing the font. Here, you can do it. So this is the font options. Understood clearly? The font option is nothing. If you want to change the styles, or else if you want to change the colors, borders, bold, italic, all those we can see in home menu bar in font. Okay, next, alignments. alignments if you want to do. For example, in alignments we have different types of alignments, top align and this one top middle align, and here right side, okay, bottom side. This if you want to mention, okay, how to mention. For example, these numbers I am taking, this I want to align middle, or I want to align to left side. It is in right side, right? So I want to align a middle. So what the cells you want to align, just select the cells and go to here, align, top align, or else select middle align, or else select bottom align. Okay, for I want to align just middle, middle if you want, middle. For example, let's say clarity. This I want standing here. This, it is in a middle, right? First one, top align. See, top align, middle, and here bottom. Top, middle, bottom. Same if you want in top, I need left or I need right side. So these are the left, right, middle. Okay, in top, left. In top only, middle, and right side. Top only if you want to select at left, middle, right. You want to do like that. Okay, and next, in middle, middle also same, left, middle, right. Okay, in middle also if you want the mentioned data, left, middle, right. Same in bottom, in bottom, left, middle, right. Okay, in top if you want, same, left, middle, right. In middle, left, middle, right. In bottom, left, middle, right. So where you want to mention the data, in top or bottom or middle if you want to do, we can select it. Okay, just I want in middle, top in middle, middle and here, middle alignment. Okay, this we can do with the help of these alignments. And next, here we can see orientations. Orientation means angle clockwise, like for example angle counterclockwise, like this. Means in a different style if you want to do like this. Okay, it based on our selection, or maybe if you want to do with the help of only heading, or heading we can do, or else with data, or with data we can do. Select here angle clockwise, okay, like this. Vertical, rotate, okay, then text down, format, like this. Same options here we can see. So same if you want to turn, okay, this is the alignments. And here we can see decrease indent and increase indent. Same alignments, it will go slowly. See here, decrease indent, increase. Some slowly from 1 inch you want to move it, we can move like this, increase like this. Okay, in alignments we can see directly it go to right, directly go to left, left means middle, or else right, like that. If you don't want that much gap, only some if you want to move with the help of this increase decrease, we can move it. See, increase data, decrease data, like this. Okay, can be moved. Here we can set. Okay, and next we can see here wrap text. Wrap text means, for example, I'm writing here employee sheet. Employee sheet is in Excel. Okay, like this. This is the wrap text. If you are writing any long matter in a single cell, and student like this. If you want to do, just select here wrap text. See, here we can see the data. Employee sheet is in Excel and student data, like this. Wrap text means the whatever the matter you have written, if you want to see totally, we can do with the help of this wrap text. And here merge and center, merge and center, same, merge and center if you want, just select here. For example, these two, see here, also the example, student data. Student data is in a single, right? So, same I am selecting here, student data, if you want to merge and center. Merge is nothing but the two cells dividing in a single cell, okay? Two cells if you want to combine in a single cell, that is the merge and center. These I am selecting these two cells and select here merge and center. See here, this is the merge and center. This is used for any heading, subheadings, okay? If you want to do that, we can use this merge and center. Merge and center, okay? Merge across. So all we can do it like this. Unmerge cells if you want to do unmerge. This is the merge and center. So this is the alignment. We have seen font and we have seen alignment here. Okay. And next, numbers also if you want to see. Numbers. Numbers here. For example, I'm writing some numbers. 1, 2, like this. Okay. Like this. This is the example. And here we have different type. General. Select here. General. General means normal numbers. Number. Okay. Then the decimal values. Okay. Currency means if you want to add the symbols. Currency symbol if you want to add, just select the cells where you need to add the currency symbols. Just select here. We can add the currency symbols here. Okay. Dates. Dates if you want to add short date or long date here. Time if you want to add. This I'll say you. And here percentage if you want to add, just select here and we can add the percentage, fraction. Okay, here like this you can add it. General here, before going to date and long, short date and long date, here we can set decimal values if you want to increase. So if you want to increase, just select here decimal values, it will be increased. Okay, it is see here, we can see the ash, something else in these cells. So if you want to do, just extend this, nothing, okay? And if you want to decrease, we can decrease the values. Okay, the options, whatever we have seen here, here we can observe. Okay, you want to insert percentage, okay, all this if you want to do. No, want to add the symbols in English, Indians, okay, United States if you want to do, we can do this. Rupees, in rupees if you want, in rupees. US type, like this, China, okay? And do this. And this one percentage you have seen, and decimals, increasing and decreasing the decimals. Okay, and if you want to mention in a form of percentages, all those if you want to do, we can do in numbering. Okay, and dates if you want to mention, just select here general, more number formats. Here we can see here date, select the date. The date for sample I am taking here 14/3/2012. Just place the cursor. Select the date type here. Okay. Like this. We can see if you want short date and long date means. Short date means only we can observe like this. 19 March 20. Long date means the total. Whatever you have mentioned the date. For example, March means it displays the March. Okay. And displays the month, year, all those. It will be displayed. Can see here this, can take it date, okay, select here, it's not showing right, select long date if you want, long date. So I'll show you. Okay. Long date, see you. Short date if you want short date, long date, long date. 1st January, this. Short date. So these are the numbers. Here we can see different. We have what we have explained here: font, border, fill, protection, alignment, numbers, all those we can see here. Okay, thank you, and we can see next topic, styles, in next class. Okay.